Hi everyone, this is Anil Bhatia again from PAT Fun Begins Practical Architectural Training, a unit of ADS Architects Design Studio. Today we are going to talk about a very controversial topic, Vastu Shastra. It's a deep subject and I am going to talk about the basics of Vastu Shastra, because every time you will meet a client, 90% he will ask you if you have knowledge of Vastu, basic knowledge of Vastu. Even the client does not expect you to have a complete detailed knowledge. For that, he will arrange an expert. But yes, he expects you to have basic knowledge so that when you discuss with his Vastu consultant, you are already aware about the basics. So, what are the basic concepts? Let us start with the plot shape. Have a look on the left. We made a few diagrams. One should avoid buying an oval, a triangular, or an L-shaped plot. One should always try to buy a square or rectangular plot. The reason is that odd shapes cause uneven distribution of energies and this could be harmful. Here at the start itself, I may add that the reasons for this are mentioned in old Indian mythology too. And for me as an architect, I will not go into that. Only a Vastu expert with deep knowledge can go into the reasons. I shall not be going into these details. The second part is the direction of the front of the house. It is commonly believed that only north and east facing plots are good. This is also not true. Let me make a diagram of the plot and explain this to you. Have a look at the left. In this diagram, each side of the plot is divided into 9 parts. These 9 parts are called 9 padas. If we extend all these lines, we will get 9 into 9, 81 squares. And the central square shall be the central pada, the Brahma Stham. Now, look at the diagram again. But we shall now color some padas in green color. The padas which are in green color are the positions from where entry to the house is good or auspicious. This means that even in the south facing plot, which you can see there, if you enter from that one green pada, which is the fourth pada of the area of the length from the southeast corner, then it is fine. And this south facing plot is okay. Not a bad decision to buy this plot at all. And the three padas to the right of this are also okay for entry. But we must try to include the green marked pada as part of the total entry. So let's banish the myth that a south facing plot is a bad buy. So why do we always say that the plot should be facing either north or east? Let's look at the east entry of the plot now. If you have an east entry plot, the green marking in the fifth pada, which is the central pada, and even the two padas on its left and all four on its right are also good for entry. So, it is easy to understand why an east facing plot is thought to be good. Because the plot can have so many padas for entries. In the east facing plot, only the two padas from the left corner, which is the southeast corner, are bad for entry. Similarly, if the plot faces north, then if you have a look at the diagram again, the central pada is marked green. That means very, very good for entry. And all the padas on the left are also good, and all the right padas also good. So in a north facing plot, no pada is bad for entry at all. That is why a north facing plot is considered very good. Now let's look at the west facing plot. This has four padas marked in green. These four are good, and even the two padas on the left are good towards the northwest. Only the southwest three padas are bad for entry. So we can easily conclude that this is not true that south and west facing plots are bad. But if we go deep into Vastu, then there are other things to be checked, things which are connected with the owner's birth details, etc., which have to be correlated to. Hence, if your belief is to understand the entry points deeper, you will surely need a Vastu consultant. We are here to explain the basics of Vastu only, and you will always need a Vastu consultant who has deeper knowledge. Now, let us learn broadly which direction is suitable for the main staircase of the house. That means, where do you keep the main staircase of the house on a plot? Which direction is good for the kitchen, and which direction is good for the bedrooms? Also, which direction is good for a puja room, and where all you can locate the toilets in a house. So let's again look at the plot diagram. We shall be always considering north as pointing upwards. This does not mean that the entry is from south. This just means, for convenience, we are locating the plot showing north upwards. We are first going to look into the correct location for the staircase in a house. As you can see in the diagram on the left, the best location for the staircase is shown in green. This means the southwest corner of the house. Southwest corner is the best. And then there are two second best locations, mainly the exact south and the exact west. The next thing to note about the staircase is that while going up the staircase, we should always be moving in the clockwise direction. And the third thing to know is that the number of risers in a staircase should be such that when this number is divided by 3, then the remainder is always 2. Let us take an example. If the number of risers is 17, then 17 divided by 3 is 5, plus 2 is the remainder. So the number of risers as 17 is good. Let's take another example. Let's say risers are 18. Then 18 divided by 3 is 6 with no remainder. Hence, 18 risers in a staircase are considered wrong. The basics of the Vastu of staircase are over. Now, let's study the location of the kitchen in a house. The best location for a kitchen is the southeast zone, as shown on the left in green color. Southeast corner of the house is the best location. The second best is the northwest zone. the second best location is okay, but it will increase the expenditure of the house as per Vastu. The worst position shown is the pure north. Here the increase in expenditure is supposed to go beyond control. Now let's look at the inside layout of the kitchen. The first thing is the cooking range, the most important thing in a kitchen. While facing the cooking range, the cook should always be facing east. Secondly, the sink should be in the northeast corner of the kitchen, northeast corner. Thirdly, the south of the wall of the kitchen can have the gas burner in the southeast corner, and the remaining south counter can be used for other things like microwave, oven, etc. Have a look at the diagram of the kitchen. One important factor is that the kitchen should not be located above or under a puja room or a toilet. As per Vastu, if you face west while cooking, that is exactly the opposite direction, then there are health issues for the person who cooks. And if you face south while cooking, then there are huge monetary issues for the household. We have now understood basics for staircase and kitchen. Let's now understand about bedrooms. The first and the most important thing to understand is the bed position. While sleeping, the best direction that your head can be is south. This gives wealth and prosperity. And if your head while sleeping is in the west direction, then this gives name, reputation and riches. And if your bed is in the east direction, this gives you peace and spiritualism. The only direction that is actually bad is north. Head while sleeping should never be in the north direction. Now let's look at the location of the bedrooms. The southwest corner is the best for the master bedroom. The east zone is good for unmarried children's room. And the west is good for all children. Have a look at the screen. The west is good for all children. And the southeast for the unmarried son. Now let's look at the location of the puja room in the house. The best location is northeast corner of the house. Then there are two other zones which are also good. The pure east and the pure west zone. Some things should be kept in mind that the puja room should never be adjoining a toilet or a kitchen. Try to avoid puja room inside a bedroom. Puja room should never be under the staircase. These three things are shown diagrammatically. Now, puja room should preferably be on the ground floor if the whole house is owned by one person. And never should the puja room be in the pure south side as shown on the left. We should not have a dustbin in the puja room. No money should be stored here. And photos of family members who have passed away should never be kept in the puja room. So, till now, we have understood about staircase, kitchen, bedroom, and puja room. The next important thing is the location of toilets in a house. As you can see in the diagram again, the best location is given. There are three such locations marked in green, and the other two are the second best locations marked in yellow. Remember, the corner areas of the house are absolutely a no-no for a toilet. No corners of the house should have a toilet, especially in the northeast corner. The locations on the east and west, as you can see, are slightly above the pure east and pure west. They're slightly above. And the pure north should be avoided. Now, let's see the layout inside the toilet. Now, look at the diagram of the toilet on the left. You will notice mostly all the fittings, such as WC, shower, wash basin, and the tub, should be on the north wall of the toilet. This way, the mirror on the wash basin is also on the north wall. The southeast corner should be the position of the geyser, southeast corner. And if possible, the door should be in the northeast zone. Now, we have mostly understood the basic locations of all areas in a house. There are certain other criteria of vastu, and we shall discuss these in detail in the next video. We shall also introduce you to our vastu expert in the next video. Again, I must mention the interns who helped me in the presentation, Sanchi and Manvi, and my staff who helped me in the presentation also, and editing too, Shubham and Sagarika. And as usual, Siddharth helped me in the photography. Please feel free to email any query of yours. The email ID is mentioned below. Till our next video on Vastu, bye, take care.